Assalamu alaikum. This is modern control theory. We are discussing state space representation. This is the third class on state space representation. We'll be discussing article 3.6 in this class. So the article 3.6 is converting state space to transfer function. Okay, so if state space representation is provided, then how can you convert it to the conventional frequency domain transfer function? So say we have our state equation given as x dot equal to ax plus bu, and the output equation is given as y equal to cx plus du. So first of all, we have to take Laplace transformation of both of them. So Laplace transformation will give us something like this: SXS equal to AXS plus BS and YS equal to CXS into DUS. Okay, so always remember one assumption you always take is initial condition zero while you're actually deriving initial conditions of Z. So from this one, what we can have is take A into the other side. So SXS minus AXS equal to BUS. So if you take all of the x's, you have to be careful because these are vector quantities. So we just cannot take arbitrary common. So x's is the second parameter, so it will be going to the right side. So I is the identity matrix. So as then x's equal to B inverse. So we have to find out what is XS, then the value of XS has to be placed into this equation to find out the value of YS. So again, these are matrix or n vector quantities, that is why. And we have to multiply with the inverse matrix here in this, in both sides. Directions are very, very important. XS equal to okay, so eventually these two matrix will be canceling each other and we'll have our excess equal to SI minus A inverse B inverse. Now from this equation, finally our YS will be equal to C, just replace the value of XS as I minus A inverse. Sorry, inverse. BUS plus DUS. Okay, so eventually C is I minus A inverse B US plus D US So US can be taken common. So eventually what we are going to get is C plus R minus A inverse B plus D into US equal to Y. So this is actually, we can say that output YS by input US equal to C plus R minus A inverse B plus D. So this is our transfer function, closed loop transfer function. And inverse matrix can also be figured out in this way, C into adjacent of SI minus A divided by determinant of SI minus A. Just multiply with B and C, then plus D. So this is your closed loop transfer function. Okay, so let us go for one example. The example will simplify the thing. So example 3.6. So what is provided is x dot equal to 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Then we have x plus 10, 0, 0, u. Okay, so how many state variables or phase variables are there? Now from the matrix, even though they are not mentioning, you can easily say that there has to be three of them. So basically X has to be something like this, X1, X2, and X3. And also the output equation is given, Y equal to 1, 0, 0, X. So from this form, we can conclude that this actually means that your y equal to x1. So basically, there is no dynamic terms in the numerator of the transfer function. It should not be formed this way. Okay. So, but we have to see what are the transfer function that is coming and whether there is some exceptions there or not. Let us start with the what we have to find out. The T of S has to be actually C SI minus A inverse B plus D. Luckily, we don't have any D in this equation, so we have to identify the facts that we have available. This is A. This is B and this is our C. So you can omit this part. So ultimately what we have is C into adjacent of SI minus A into B. The order cannot be altered because they're matrix. Then we have determinant of SI minus A. Now let's start with the solution. So S into I, I is the identity matrix minus A. So basically S multiplied by 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, identity matrix minus 0, A matrix is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Okay, so what we have is S, 0, 0, 0, S, 0, zero zero s minus zero one zero 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 one minus one minus two minus three. So what you have is s minus one zero zero s minus one zero. Sorry, it has to be. Plus 1, so this will be 1, 2, and then s minus minus 3 is basically s plus 3. So this is our SA minus A. So next, what we have to do is we have to find out the adjacent and determinant of SI minus A. So for finding the adjacent, what you have to do is we have to find out the values of the coefficients of different location, as well as then we have to find out the transpose of that, that will give us the adjacent matrix. And it's just a reminder, this before finding the coefficient of this position, we have to find out this would be the symbol, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. Just review, I think you already know. Then each parameter, what you have to do, multiply, cross, then subtract, and then multiply in this cross. So basically for the first one, what you have is, the sign is definitely positive. Then we have S into S plus three. So this basically what we'll have is S squared plus 3s, multiply these two, then subtract these two. So minus minus, it will be plus, so this will be plus 2. Okay, so for the second position, which you need to multiply this one, and subtract this one and this one. So this will give us basically. Position itself is having a minus sign, and then minus minus plus, so this will be minus one will be here. And third one will be just multiplication of this one and this one and this one and this one. So this will give us basically 0 minus s. So the plus sign will be there. As well as, since the magnitude here is zero, so this parameter has to be zero. Then it cross multiply. Now, the second position again, okay. The second position here will give us zero again. Why? Because this magnitude is zero, so zero. And then third one will be, plus sign. Okay. Actually, that magnitude is not, will not be considered, rather only the sign. So the third one, only if you take the sign, then it will actually give you the plus, and then you will have, zero minus minus s. So minus s will be there. So sometimes easy things also become difficult to recall. So that is always better to review the things. Okay, now only the sign is there, so minus sign will be there. So what will now what you have to do, this one will be multiplied with this one. Okay, and that is minus s plus 3 minus 0. So this is really minus minus is really plus plus s plus. Okay, next term is this one multiplied by this one, and then it will be s into s plus 3, so s into s plus 3, the sign is positive. And the third one will be, for this one, this equivalent, it will be multiplied, you have to multiply this parameter with this parameter, okay? That is twice s, then minus plus 1. So because of the minus sign, you have minus twice s plus 1. Okay, similarly, for this parameter, you have to multiply this 2, and then you have to multiply this 2. So basically, you are going to get minus 1, so minus, basically plus 1 will be here. And the second parameter, just do a bit of analysis, you are going to see s, and this will be ss. Then you have to take the transpose, obviously. So rows will be column, column will be row. So what we are going to get is s square plus 3s plus 2 minus 1 minus s. Then s plus 3, s into s plus 3 minus twice s plus 1. Then 1s, s square. So this is our adjacent matrix. Now we have to find out the determinant as well. So determinant of Si minus A. So for finding the determinant, again, go to back to the matrix. That is basically S minus 1, 0, 0, S minus 1, 1, 2, and S plus 3. So we have to find out the determinant of this matrix. So it is relatively easier. So S into first parameter into these two cross multiplication, S into S plus 3 minus plus 2. So then next parameter is minus 1, okay, into minus 1 into, then you have to multiply this one with this one, which is 0. And then you have to multiply with this one. So minus, you are going to get 1. Okay, so plus 1 will be here. And one of the last one, because you are multiplying with 0, so I do not know 0. So what you are going to get is S into S square plus 3S plus 2 plus 1. So simply S cubed plus 3S square plus twice S plus 1. So we have adjacent, we have determinant. Now, adjacent matrix has to be multiplied with what we know is C into adjacent Si minus A into B. Then we have to divide it by determinant of Si minus. Determinant is already determined. Now just multiply those two. So adjacent Si minus A into B. So adjacent is already figured out, that is S square plus 3s plus 2, then s plus 1, 1, then minus 1, minus s, s into s plus 3, minus twice s plus 1, then we have s, s square. Okay, with that one, the matrix was 10. 0, 0. So if you just multiply, so the first column will be remaining, and also when we multiply with 10, so 10 into s square plus 3s plus 2, and the other two is just multiplied with 0 will be 0, and minus 10 minus 10s. Okay. So next is you have to multiply C into the thing already we figured out at just enough, SI minus A into B. Okay. So what is symmetric? Symmetric is basically 100, so 100 with 10 SI square plus 3S plus 2, then minus 10 minus 10S. So since only the first parameter is available, the other two will multiply with 0. So what we are going to do is 10 into S square plus 3S plus 2. So we have both of them. So this value as well as the determinant. So you can finally write our transfer function T of S equal to C into adjacent of SI minus 1 inverse into B divided by determinant of SI minus A. Okay, so finally you can write that the numerator is 10 into S square plus 3S plus 2, and the determinant is S cube plus 3S square plus 2S plus 1. So this is our required solution or required transfer function of frequency domain. So this is how we can actually either convert. In the last article, we have seen that 3.5, that how to convert transfer function into a state space. And in this article, 3.6, we actually have seen how to convert the state space into transfer function. This one actually a bit involved because of the fact that it actually deals with the matrices and the order has to be maintained. So this is the end of chapter 3. Few other topics is left, but that is actually beyond the curriculum of this course. So we end the chapter 4 here, and inshallah in the next class we will start chapter 3. Sorry, start chapter 4. The portion of the chapter 4 that deals with state space representation. So that will inshallah start in the next class. Okay, assalamu alaikum.